Madam President, first of all, I can't tell you what a pleasure it has been working with Chairman Murkowski. We've been able to show, and even before with Senator Cantwell as a ranking member before, and the committee, working in a bipartisan way. So when people think that it's broken, it's really not broken. It might be wobbling a little bit, but it might need some repairs. In the Energy and Natural Resource Committee on the Senate side, we've showed that it can be done. But there has to be a matter of trust. You have to trust each other, and you have to basically communicate to work through these. And we've been able to do that. When there have been a little bit of concerns pop up from time to time, we get together. Senator Murkowski and I have called and talked to each other and worked through it. And we've talked with the chairman and ranking member over on the House to make sure they're in lockstep with us. And we've moved through this. And we look for this to be extremely successful as it reaches the House. These bills are going to improve the way public lands are managed and conserved at the ground level. And while these bills are important to the residents of small towns across America, many of the bills in this package do not have a significant impact outside their local sphere. So these are truly local bills. And as such, it is rare these bills to receive consideration on the Senate floor. Really what we're saying is by themselves, it would be hard to move something like this. As a package, and it takes so long, it's been, what, 4 years, I believe, since the last?
Five.
5 years since the last land package has been done. And that's really the reason it's been quite time consuming. I want to again thank the tireless work of my colleagues, of course, Senator Chairman Murkowski, Ranking Member Maria Cantwell, Senator Heinrich, and Senator Gardner and Senator Daines on the Republican side. Everyone has worked very well together. I also want to thank the committee staff, because the committee staff and the floor staff is really what makes this happen and this package come together, and they've worked tirelessly. So all the outside groups have brought all their information to us. We were able to work with them, and it was quite fulfilling. The package has been warmly received by both Democrats and Republicans, and from our conversations with folks in the House, we are expecting it to receive the warm reception over there as well. I cannot tell you how many members are excited to get this to the President's desk for his signature. We add 1,000 of miles to our national trail system, designates over 1.3 million acres of wilderness, designates hundreds of miles of wild and scenic rivers, and will improve hunting, fishing, and recreation access to our federal lands. Madam President, I have said before, our public lands are truly one of our nation's greatest treasures, and we are so fortunate to have so many special places that we set aside for the public to enjoy. Each year, 67% of the people of West Virginia take to the outdoors to enjoy our wild and wonderful areas. In my state of West Virginia, it's truly almost heaven because of the access we have and the beauty we have. Again, in my state of West Virginia alone, outdoor recreation supports 91,000 direct jobs. 91,000 jobs is a lot of jobs in a state of our size, but really in any state, and $9 billion in consumer spending. The centerpiece of this package is the permanent reauthorization of the Land, Water, and Conservation Fund. This is truly the part of the legislation that really carries the water, figuratively speaking. This is simply yet highly effective conservation tool with unrivaled success over the last 50 years. Unfortunately, the LWCF expired last September, but this package will reinstate the program to ensure states and federal public land management agencies can continue to protect and conserve our natural resources. Since 1965, more than $243 million in LWCF funds have been spent in West Virginia on more than 500 projects, both on state and federal lands. This includes improvements to local parks, public spaces in 54 of our state's 55 counties, and it does so without relying on taxpayer dollars. And I again want to highlight the long-awaited priorities for sportsmen groups included in this package. Hunting in all of our states, in my state as West Virginia, is our oldest pastimes. The friends and families gather and spend quality time. It's important that we provide opportunities to keep these traditions alive. The Natural Resource Management Act will expand and enhance sportsman access by making federal lands throughout West Virginia and the nation open unless closed for fishing, hunting, recreational shooting, and other outdoor activities. Myself as a hunter and a vice chairman of the Congressional Sportsman's Caucus, I know how frustrated sportsman groups have been in trying to get their bills passed the last few years. That's why I'm so pleased that so many of our priorities are included in this package. So I am pleased to say that the Natural Resource Management Act will establish several national heritage areas, including one in West Virginia, the Appalachian Forest National Heritage Area. This local heritage area has been operating as an ad hoc national heritage area for more than a decade. By providing the official NAH designation, the Appalachian Forest Heritage Area can earn the national recognition it deserves, and is now also eligible for grants and technical assistance from the National Park Service. This will enable the heritage area to take the services they provide to the region to the next level. So I believe that this package is a great bill for both Republicans and Democrats and all of our friends. Numerous pieces of legislation have been longstanding priorities for many members, and they have been included. I'd like to thank Chairman Mikowski again, as well as the other members of the Energy and Natural Resource Committee, all the staff members, the floor members, for their efforts to reach an agreement on this bill. I'd also like to thank the Majority Leader for his willingness to bring this bill to the floor in such an expedited manner. I believe it's time this bill gets over to the House and to the President for a signature. So I want to thank all that's been involved, and I note the absence of a quorum.